I'm going to make a VT graph. What is velocity time graph? It tells you the velocity of a particle which is going in a straight line, by the way, at any given time t. Okay, what is the velocity? So say the graph is something like this. I'll mark some values. So this is say 2. This would be 4. That would be 6. All in seconds. Time is in seconds. So keep making with me. That's your 8. Okay, that's your velocity time graph. Is it clear? I'll write some velocities also. I'll put it as 1, so this looks like 3. This is meter per second. Shall I ask you a few questions on this? Have you made the graph?
Yes. So.
Okay, question number 1. What is the distance traveled from 0 seconds to 2 seconds? Distance and displacement from 0 second to 2 seconds. Distance, displacement. Time is equal to 0 to 2. T is equal to 0 to 2. Give me the answer. Write the answer in the private thing. I should see 2 answers, this comma this. Write the answer in the private chat. So from a VT curve, how do you get the displacement? Anybody tell me? Just speak up. From a VT curve, how do you get the displacement?
You find the area. You find the area under the graph.
The VT curve is the displacement. Slope of the VT curve is your acceleration. As simple as that, right?
Yes, sir.
Right? So if I say what is the displacement? Displacement is straight away the area under the VT curve. Now, whether the displacement is going to be the distance or not, we will debate it, we will check out. But let me first tell the displacement. So this is this area we are talking about, right? 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 Right, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So how much is that area?
4 meters.
How much is that area? This box area, that triangle area. The box area is 2. Right? 1 into 2. And the triangle area is how much? Half into base into height. Get the point? That means half the box. Half this box. This is a 2 and this height is a 2. So this box area is 4. So this triangle area is 2 again, right? Right or not?
Right, sir.
So this area is 4. Why did you not get 4 as the answer? People who did not get 4 as the answer, ask me your doubt. Because the lesson has ended. It should be very, very clear to you.
Otherwise, calculate
the other lesson. And after a few lessons, you'll completely forget what was happening over here. So if you're getting something wrong, it will become a bigger problem later on. Is this okay? The displacement is 5. Now, people have written distance as various things. I would have never asked you what is the distance, but I just thought, let me ask what is the distance. So I'll come back to the distance again. People are writing various answers, so I'm quite curious and I want to know one thing. You can say, do I have the permission to speak? I say yes, speak, then you will speak up. My question is, at what time the body starts going backwards? Mind you, the body is going in a straight line. It's a straight line motion with varied velocity. Velocity is becoming high, low, or whatever. At what time the velocity starts going backwards?
Four seconds.
What?
4 seconds.
You ask your name. You tell your name first. Ask me permission.
I'm Tushar.
Can Tushar. Okay, hold on. Tushar has an answer. Anybody else?
Sir, huh? I'm Arushi. I have an answer too.
Okay, Arushi, Tushar. Only two people can look at the graph and tell the body will go back at what place.
Sir, even I have an answer. I'm Vaishnav.
Vaishnav, okay. Three. Then? Nobody said. Since when was it paused? Okay, doesn't matter. We are all full attendance, right? So what we discussed is this was all positive velocity. So it was going forward all the time till 4 seconds. After 4 seconds, the velocity became negative. That means it turned back and started going back. If the velocity graph is going down, doesn't mean the body is going backwards. It just means that the velocity is decreasing. It is still positive velocity. Positive velocity means forward movement. Negative velocity means backward movement. So this region is of backward movement. This region is of forward movement. Okay. Now next, what I've asked is the displacement from T2 to T6, and yes, people had figured out that this dipping point, this velocity over here, is a minus 3 meter per second, because in 2 seconds the graph dropped by 3 meter per second. In further 2 seconds, it is dropping by further 3 meter per second. Given that this is a straight line, yeah. Okay, displacement. Punch in your answer.
In my answer in the chat.
Chat. Yes, displacement as well as distance from 0 to 6 seconds, displacement and distance.
Or you mean from 2 to 6, right?
Yeah, sorry, 2 to 6 seconds. Time 2 to time 6 seconds. Distance and displacement, both of it. Fast.
Sir.
I should see all answers.
Sir.
Everybody should have an answer.
Answer.
Okay, now again, I am again saddened to see wrong answers. What is the distance or displacement from 2 to 4? That's this area, right? How much is that area? Half base into height.
Three.
So that's 3.
3 meters.
Half base into height is 3, right? Half into 2 into the height. The height was 3. So that is 3, right?
Yeah.
Point? Some people are writing this as 6. I don't know why. Suppose you got it as three. Further, you are doing mistakes. From 2 to 4, how is the movement? How is the body moving? Say this was 2 seconds. 2 seconds. From 2 to 4, how is the body moving? Forward or back?
Forward.
Forward. It moves 3 meters forward by slowing down. And at 4 seconds, it becomes zero velocity, right? At four seconds, it becomes zero velocity, right?
Yes, sir.
Good point. From 2 to 4, it was moving forward. Now 4 to 6, how is the body moving?
In opposite direction.
Velocities are negative, right?
It's the same. This is what in the negative.
What?
Way, like backwards. It's the same thing except backwards.
It is moving backwards, right? From 4 to 6, right? So it is moving backwards. Yeah. From where it ended at 4 seconds, it ended over here. It is moving backwards. Now, how much?
So the magnitude is same, like 3. Magnitude is same, but the direction.
Calculate this area. How much backwards? So this area will tell you the displacement from 4 to 6. But 4 to 6 displacement is backward displacement. How much is that? Again, half base into height. Half of base is 2 and height is 3. Will give you 3 again. So you are back on the same spot, right? 3 meter forward you went and 3 meter backward you are going, right? And you land up exactly at the same spot, right? So if I ask you what is the displacement from 2 to 6, it's 0 or not? Displacement doesn't care that you went to Pakistan and came back or what. Displacement just says that where you started and where you ended, right? Right?
Yes, sir.
You started at 2 seconds, you were here. At 6 seconds, you are back over here. So the displacement is zero. What's the distance traveled? Obviously, the distance is how much you actually went. So you went 6 meters, right? 3 meters and 3 meters, right? So displacement is zero and distance is 6 meters, right?
Yes, sir.
So why people got it wrong? I was not planning to ask. Now I have to ask.
Excuse me, sir.
What is the displacement and distance from 0 to 8 seconds? Yes. Who is that?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
This is Shreya speaking. Can I speak?
Yeah, yeah. You're, speak a little louder. You're away from the mic.
Sir, the actually the displacement will be minus 4.
Displacement
it started from one. It started from one, and when it reaches to one, that time the displacement is
again. Very slowly. Your mic is not good at all. You speak either you come close to the mic or speaks little slowly.
Sir is telling the motion started from.
Let him speak. Let him speak. Let him speak.
Sir, the motion started from one.
Started from one. What do you mean by started from one?
It was 1 meter per second.
Started from one means what?
If the body was moving with 1 meter per second. And
body was moving with 1 meter per second. Yeah, okay, big deal.
And sir, if you draw a straight line.
Yes. Yeah, okay.
The displacement over there will be zero, sir.
No, what? I did not understand what he said. Body started its motion when time was zero. Body had a speed of 1 meter per second. Yeah. How does it matter? Before this, it had some other speed.
Sir, can you draw like a line?
When you little slowly you speak and little loudly.
So when the body was retarding.
That means from here.
Yeah, from 2 seconds.
Yeah.
And when it came to 1 meter per second.
When the speed came to 1 meter per second, yes. Like somewhere over
here. Yeah. That time the displacement is zero.
That time the displacement is zero. Who said that? Like how?
Because sir, it started from the 1 meter per second. That was the initial point.
Nobody's asking displacement from time zero to this time. By the way, it is not zero then also. But nobody asked this. By the way, it is not zero then also. Do you think, I mean, you're wrong in various accounts. Do you think that this area plus this area is 4, first of all? This area you are saying is 4. Where is that person gone? Who was speaking?
Yes, sir, it's not.
Yeah, don't go away. Just tell me.
Yeah.
From here to here, it went somewhere, right?
Yeah.
0 to 2. How much it went? Tell me. I'll just make a line. I'll have to make a big line. So I'll start making from here. This is coming in the board. Okay. 0 seconds. 0 to 2. How much it went?
It moved.
How much?
4 meters.
Huh?
4 meters.
4 meters. You have any doubt in that, or shall we debate that also?
No, I don't have any.
Okay. 4 meters is it went, and this is like 2 second. End of 2 second. Right?
Yes, sir.
And by the way, what is the speed over here? Just for my curiosity, what is the speed over here?
3 meter per second.
It is 3 meter per second still forward, right?
Yes,
right?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. After that, what do you think? From 2 to 4, forget about this thing which we'll have to calculate how much it is. It will be like 2.66. It will be like 3 seconds over here, but I don't want to calculate right now, because if we require, we'll do that. But let me just tell you, let me just ask, from 2 to 4, what do you think, how much it went?
It uniformly retarded.
What? It
uniformly retarded.
Yeah, retarded. Retarded means what? Went back or went forward?
Went forward, but with decreasing velocity.
Yeah, decreasing. So how much it went? I did not ask.
Another 4 meters.
Huh?
4 meters.
Four? How 4, man?
minus 4.
How minus 4, man? How 4? How the number 4 and how the number minus? Both I have big issues with both of it. First, how did you get 4 from here to there?
Sorry, sir, it's 3.
Okay, 3. How did you get a minus?
No, it's only 3, so positive.
No, you said minus, no?
No, sorry, it's
a mistake, sir. Why it is plus?
Because it's moving in the straight.
Because it is moving forward. It is moving forward. If you are driving a car, you have speeded up initially and then you start braking. Starting the brake means retarding, doesn't mean you have started going backwards, right?
Yes, sir.
Abhi tum, if you ask your dad to slow down a bit, doesn't mean you started going backwards, no. So from 2 to 4, it went further 3 meters. So I'll make that. 3 meters more I made. 3 meters. And this is my 4 seconds. So that funny time in between, what was that time?
3.33
whatever. How is it like zero displacement at that time? What displacement is zero? First of all, from here to there, I'm not even asking the displacement. I'm asking from 2 to 6, how much is the displacement? So what was happening initially, I don't care also. But suppose I cared also. Still, if I ask from 0 also, so 0 to 4 seconds, is not a zero displacement. Zero to this in between somewhere is also not zero displacement. It's a big time displacement. From here to here, it's a 7 meter displacement. There's a point.
Yes, I see.
Thirdly, this steepness and this steepness is not same. This is more steep, that is less steep. Why? In 2 seconds, we have risen by 2. And here in 2 seconds, we have fallen by 3. So this calculation, what you were saying, that calculation itself was a little wrong. But even though I'd wasted time in calculating that, my point was something else. So that point would have got missed. So we never calculated that. Okay. In 2 seconds, it falls by 3. 3 fall in 2 seconds. 1 fall in how much seconds? A fall of 3 in 2 seconds. A fall of 1 in how much seconds? A fall in the graph of 3 in 2 seconds.
Yes, sir.
It will fall by 1 in how much seconds? Fall by 1 in 2 by 3 seconds.
Yes, sir.
So in a 2 by 3 seconds, 2 plus 2 by 3, the speed will come to 2 meter per second, it will fall by 1. And in another 2 by 3 seconds, it will fall by another 1. So this thing will be 2 plus 2 by 3 plus 2 by 3, 2 plus 4 by 3, which is 3.33, which I don't want to calculate. Simply to go off topic, I don't want to do that. So I asked, what is the displacement from here to there? Now what happens after 4 seconds, 4 to 6, the velocity has reversed. Very low backward velocity, but increases, and this is 3. This is 3 distance or displacement. Okay, so how much is that? 3 which way? 3 backwards. So from here, it starts coming backwards and comes exactly 3 at 6 seconds. 6 seconds, he is back over here, right?
Yes, sir.
So even if you have understood that what is the total displacement would have been 0 to this point, which is 4 meters. But I ask you, what is the displacement between 2 to 6 seconds, which is 0. No displacement.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now get me the distance and displacement. Distance and displacement traveled from 0 to 8. What do you think? Ultimately, looking at the graph, what does it look like? Will it be a forward or a backward? Ultimately, the thing has landed backwards or forwards?
Backwards. Backwards.
Yeah, more area looks at the bottom, less area on the top, right?
Yes.
But we'll calculate and get the exact thing. So calculate and get the exact thing. Lalit, sir. Lalit. My God. Somebody please remind me to. So we calculated that it went 6 meters further backwards. So we had drawn that at 6 seconds it was here. First 4 meter forward, then 3 meter forward, then 3 meter backward, and 6 meter further backwards. So ultimately it landed 2 meters behind the original point. That is what we have discussed. The total distance is 16. Displacement is -2. Okay. Now let me ask you, from this graph, I want to make the acceleration time graph as well as the displacement time graph. Displacement time graph might be a little tricky. Acceleration time graph is pretty cheap. So can you make the acceleration time graph for me? So before you make the graph, on this graph, with each line, can you write how much is the acceleration? I'll use a different color. Please write in your own notebooks acceleration is how much. Please write the acceleration all over. Acceleration is how much, so that you can graph it later on. Okay. I hope you know acceleration is the slope of the graph, right? Right? Yes, guys?
Yes, sir.
Slope of VT graph is acceleration, yes, right? And what, yes, do you mean, sir, by slope? What do you mean by slope?
Y2 minus Y1
divided by X2.
How much is the rise? How much is the rise when you go a certain amount forward? If you rise by y, by going x amount forward, then the slope is y by x. Get the point? In higher standards, we use the word delta to show change in y. So we call the rise as delta y, and the x change as delta x. So delta y by delta x. Okay. You go how much forward, and because of that much going forward, how much you have risen or fallen. That's your rise. So rise by forward movement is your slope. Get the point? Don't go backwards. It's time, and time goes forward. Okay. So go along with time. Written the answer. Please remind me on time, man. Thanks for reminding, by the way. So I was emphasizing that acceleration is not velocity by time. It is not velocity by time. It is change in velocity by change in time. And the change in velocity from here, from 0 seconds to 2 seconds, is 1 meter per second to 3 meter per second. So change in velocity came as an increase of 2 meter per second, and change in time was 0 to 2 was 2, so 2 by 2 is 1. And unlike if we had applied this formula v by t, which is not a formula at all, which is wrong, would have been 3 by 2. Velocity at this spot is 3, time at this spot is 2, so 3 by 2 is not the acceleration at all. So this I am rubbing off. I hope people are clear with what is acceleration, because few of them I got the acceleration like that. I got an acceleration of 1.5 in the first go itself, which is all wrong. Okay, next I was saying that the slope from here to there and there to there is same, because the line is not changing the inclination. Inclination of the line means slope. So instead of doing from here to there and then from there to there, I was proposing, let me do from here to there straight away, from 2 seconds to 6 seconds straight away. So how much is the change in velocity is what I was asking. How much is the change in velocity from 2 seconds velocity to 6 seconds velocity? How much is the change? How much is the change, guys? Anybody? Change in velocity, how much? At 2 seconds, how much is the velocity?
3 meters.
T is equal to 2 seconds. What is the velocity? 3 meter per second, right? T is equal to 6 seconds. What is the velocity? What is the velocity? What is the velocity?
-3.
-3 meter per second. I'm little surprised to see that you don't know how much is the change if I say from plus 3 to minus 3. How much is the change?
Zero.
Oh, really? Now that is again a big surprise. So this class
sir,
today is
six,
full of surprises.
Right? 6. So 6 minus 3 minus.
If I have a number line 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2. What is the difference between 2 and minus 2?
4.
4, right? Difference between 2 and 0 is a 2, but difference between 2 and minus 2 is become 0 or what? This change was 3. Everybody agrees, right? This change was 3?
Yes.
3 was a decreasing change, right?
Yes, sir.
A decrease of velocity of 3, and this is a further decrease of velocity of 3. There is a total decrease of 6, right? Straight away from a velocity of 3, it became a minus 3. 6 is the change. Got the point?
Yes, sir.
Now, people who are too much into formula, I'll write like this. Final velocity became minus 3 meter per second. Initial velocity was 3 meter per second in the time I'm talking about. In the time I'm talking, initial velocity was 3. Final velocity is that. Change in velocity is V minus U. How much is that? V is minus 3. Minus 3 minus U is how much? 3. Minus 3 minus 3 becomes how much? Minus 6 meter per second, right? Which you can see from the graph straight away that the change has become from 3, it has gone to minus 3. The velocity has changed by how much? 6 negative, right? Because 6 positive would have been 3 to plus 9, right? Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And is the time negative? Time is never negative. From 2 to how much? 6. So how much is the change in time?
4 seconds.
4 seconds is the change in time. So what do we get? We get minus 6 by 4. How much is that?
Minus 1.5.
How much is that? Minus 6 minus by 4 1. Is minus 3 by 2, which is minus
1.5.
Yeah, minus 1.5. So some people have written the answer as plus 1.5 over here. I don't know why. And this is also minus 1.5. It is minus 1.5 per meter per second all over. Velocity being positive doesn't mean acceleration is positive. Velocity being negative doesn't mean acceleration is negative. Now, if you don't want to be that adventurous that I'll take from here to there and you want to be more careful, let us take from 2 to 4. What is the change in velocity from 2 to 4?
Sir, I have a doubt.
It's a 3 to 0. 1 second. What is the change in velocity from 2 to 4? It's a 3 to 0, right? So what's the change in velocity? Minus 3, right? Minus 3.
Yes.
Minus 3. 3 to 0 is the change in velocity. Divided by, what's the time? 2 to 4. How much is the time?
2 seconds.
2 seconds. What do you get? Minus 1.5 meter per second square. You'll get the same thing. Get the point?
Yes, sir.
And if you do from here to there, 0 to minus 3. How much is the change in velocity? 0 to minus 3. Again, minus 3. What's the change in time? 2 again. You'll get again minus 1.5 meter per second square. If you see the inclination going down, acceleration is negative. Slope is negative. Big deal. Any child would say that, yeah, slope negative. Yeah, slope flat. Slope flat means zero slope, no slope. This is slope up. Slope positive. Positive slope, negative slope, flat slope. Like this is a flat slope. How much is the acceleration over here? Oh, I wrote already by mistake. How much is the acceleration over here?
Zero.
Why zero? Zero.
There's no change in velocity.
Was minus 3, the velocity remained minus 3. And the change in velocity, which is initial to final change, minus 3 to minus 3. Minus 3, minus of minus 3. Only a fool will write all that. No need to write. There has been no change, right? Right?
Yes, sir.
Divided by change in time was 2. So 0 by 2 is 0. So this is 0 acceleration. Got the point? Yeah, somebody was asking a doubt. Ask.
So, like after 4 seconds, The body is moving backwards, but then the body is accelerating, right? Like it is like moving from 0 meter per second to 3 meter per second in the opposite direction.
Backwards.
Yeah.
Accelerating backwards means retarding. Okay. Now, if I see somebody going forward, okay. Somebody is going forward with 2 meter per second. Get the point?
Yeah.
Somebody else was going forward with 5 meter per second. For the other person, this guy who was going with 2 meter per second forward looks like going back with 3 meter per second. Your acceleration is not dependent on the perception of the other guy who is in a frame which is not accelerating. Whether the velocity was increasing or decreasing, see again I'll tell you. Velocity became, suppose, from 2 meter per second to 5 meter per second. It is accelerating according to you, right? Say it.
Yes, sir.
Per second to 5 meter per second in 1 second. What is the acceleration? 3 meter per second square, right? Right?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Now, if somebody is going forward with a velocity of say 10 meter per second, for him, this guy was going back, right, with how much velocity? He was going back with 8 meter per second. He looks at the guy as going back with 8 meter per second. So it is a minus 8 meter per second velocity for this guy of him. And he sees this guy going back with 5 meter per second. So minus 5 meter per second for him. Get the point?
Yes, sir.
From minus 8 to minus 5, he is becoming velocity. Velocity is becoming from minus 8 to minus 5. It looks like he's slowing down, no, according to you. Get the point? It is very surprising. It is all a perception. From minus 8 to minus 5, the velocity is becoming. Minus 8 is deep here. So ultimately, looks like the speed is slowing down, right?
Yes,
8 speed to 5 speed. Speed looks like slowing down, right? Get the point? So this guy will say that this is decelerating from 8 speed to 5 speed. But that guy will say, who was standing, that it is accelerating from 2 to 5. For somebody, he has become faster. For somebody else, he has become slower, right? So can we have like these two different answers for the same situation? The acceleration will not be different. Okay, if you have to truly study the thing with the direction, it is same for both. In a number line, if you draw, 5 was here and 2 was here. It has been an increase of 3 extra. For the other guy also, minus 8 was here and minus 5 is here. From minus 8, it became minus 5. It has become more, not less. Get the point? I am agreeing that you with the concept of speed, it looks like it is slowing down, right? Right? And here with the concept of speed, it looks like it is accelerating, but it is decelerating. As long as, because next chapter is that. Next chapter is your force is equal to ma. Acceleration simply tells you the direction of force. F is equal to ma. Good that you have asked. We'll discuss a bit of this also. F is equal to ma. Can mass be negative or positive?
No, sir.
Is that clear that mass cannot be negative?
Yeah.
So direction of acceleration is direction of force?
Yeah.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now if I ask you in this situation, that is my made up situation. I'll remove my made up situation. I'll give you the situation where I'm asking you. The body was going with a high speed and attained a high speed of 3 meter per second. Then started slowing down and became zero. What must be the direction of the force? This was the body going with 3 meter per second and it is slowing down. After 2 seconds, it starts slowing down. Which must be the direction of force on the body?
So the opposite.
The force has to be this way, then only it is slowing down, right?
Yeah.
If it was pushing, it will become faster, right? So yes, the force was this way and it is slowing down, which is called acceleration. Which is called acceleration. It is force is as good as acceleration, just a factor of mass over there. Get the point? Now it became from 3 meters per second to 0 meters per second. After that, the body started going backwards, right?
Yes, sir.
And speeding up according to you. Yeah, it is in fact speeding up according to everybody. So first it was going, it slowed down because of force, it slowed down and then it started going backwards. What must be the direction of force?
So the
If it started going backwards with increasing velocity, opposite. What must opposite be the direction of force?
Opposite.
Still force must be this way, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So here we found out that the force is this way. Here also the force is that way, right?
Yes, sir.
Force is the direction of acceleration. So do you agree that force is backwards? That means acceleration is backwards, right?
Yes.
So it is, you may call it accelerating backwards. Okay, like wordplay, we can do it. It is absolutely right that it is speeding up backwards. But in physics, the acceleration is negative so much. Are you getting the point?
Yes, sir.
Like if I throw this thing up and it comes back, just my tube light got saved, man. It comes back. Get the point? While going up, the speed became slower, slower, slower. Acceleration due to the gravity was downwards. You can say acceleration was negative. When it is coming back, it is becoming faster. Acceleration is still downwards. And if downwards is negative, then acceleration is still negative. Are you understanding? So we'll discuss this later. Okay, this is the example, like throwing up and throwing down is the example what we generally use for. And like further on this force thing, after reaching a velocity of -3 meters per second, the body remains at -3 meters per second. What must be the force on it? After reaching -3 meters per second, the speed remains -3 meters per second.
Zero backwards. Force.
What must be the force on it?
Zero.
That's the first law. Okay. That if you have no force on it, the body will remain at the same thing. Okay. At the same constant velocity. So force was zero means acceleration was zero. Force is as good as acceleration. Got the point? Okay. Let me just draw the graph for this. This is 2 seconds. This is 4 seconds. This is 6 seconds. And that's 8 seconds. Get the point? What is the acceleration over here? 1 meter per second square all the time or not? All the time, right?
Yes.
So 1 meter per second all the time. That's your acceleration. Is that clear? Flat as that. Then what is the acceleration in this?
Minus 1.5.
So you'll jump down to -1.5. This was 1. This is -1.5. And from 2 to 6, all over like that. Fully. Okay? Fully. Get the point? And after that, 0. So that's your acceleration time graph. We'll just verify that area under acceleration time graph. What does it give? Area under acceleration time graph?
Velocity.
Change in velocity. It doesn't give velocity at all. Change in velocity.
Change in velocity.
Yeah. So like big thing, no, big difference between change in velocity by time and velocity by time. Big difference. In some 2-3 questions, velocity by time may become change in velocity by time if initial velocity is zero. Doesn't mean that velocity by time is the right thing. Okay. By fluke, 1 or 2 questions may be a misleading thing. Okay. Anyways, what is this area? This orange area, what I marked. What is this orange area? It's a pretty rectangle. What's the area?
8.
1.5.
Oh yeah. 1.5. Sorry.
Into 1.5 into. How much is this? How much is this width?
4
Yeah, why people are not speaking? 1.5 into 4, how much is that?
6.
6 is the area. What is the area in the acceleration time graph? Area in the acceleration time graph is change in velocity. Is this 6 negative or positive? Is the 6 negative or positive? Area below the line, below the
negative.
The time axis negative. Is negative, above is positive. So this change is how much? 6 negative. So did the velocity change by 6 in the actual graph from 2 to 6? Yes, it changed by 6. From here to there, it changed by 6. From plus 3 to minus 3. Are you getting the point? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, 1 second, just hold. Okay, just I was telling you that the change in area came over here. Sorry, area under the graph came over here as 2. 2 doesn't mean that 2 is a velocity. 2 is the change in velocity from time 0 seconds to time 2 seconds. So change in velocity from time 0 seconds to time 2 seconds was in fact 2. This number 2, that number 2. Now having this conceptual knowledge, you will draw the XT curve. XT curve is going to come all very curvy. It is not going to come straight line like that. Okay. So try to do that. And to do that, try to find the locations. I have already drawn the locations on the graph. At t is equal to 0, suppose the location was 0. It has to be given. So I have given at t is equal to 0, the location was 0. At t is equal to 2 seconds, what will be the location? 4 meter forward, right? 4 meter forward. So t is equal to 2 seconds. It will be 4 meter forward. This is your 4 meters. So it will be here. Get the point? Now don't be in a hurry of connecting it straight away. It can connect like that. It can connect like that. Get the point? So at 2 seconds where it is, at 4 seconds where it is, at 6 seconds where it is, at 8 seconds where it is, do all that and try to connect it in a nice curve. Whenever velocity is a slope, your XT displacement time will be a quadratic curve kind of thing. When velocity is flat, when your velocity is flat, then your displacement time curve is going to be a straight line. Velocity flat means velocity constant. Velocity constant means slope of XT constant. Slope of XT has to match VT curve. That's your homework. Okay, take your time and do. You start with laws of motion now.